Hey guys, so today I'm going to be coloring this lovely horse for you. And for those who may not know, horses are my favorite animal, so I really like this picture. There's so many other pictures in this book. It's called Craft of Coloring, and this particular book has 32 animal and nature designs, and what this is an adult coloring book, so that means it has designs that are very intricate, designs that you are meant to spend a long time and coloring on them, and you can make each design your own, color it however you want. So I personally chose the horse because I used to take horseback riding lessons when I was younger, and I'm trying to figure out what color I want to make. This horse blue and yellow. What do you think? Blue and maybe just different shades of blue. That'd be kind of cool, right? I know for one thing, I need to find black. I want to make sure I get his eye going first. It actually took me some time to figure out where his eye was in this drawing, but of all the sections, I wanted to make sure I got that right. Because the eye's important. I'm gonna leave the outer part white, and I think, well, maybe red would be kind of cool. Red is more, you know, intense, like red and orange and yellow, because it kind of looks like fire. So I think I'm gonna do that. So regular orange. Then I've also got this color, which may come in handy somewhere, which is just tan. And then I've got three different shades of yellow. I've got peach yellow and golden yellow. So I actually have another one here. Yellow, orange. So I've got a good collection here of fiery colors. I think it's gonna look really good. Okay. So these coloring books are meant for adults because they're actually geared towards those who have anxiety. Because when you concentrate on really intricate sections of a coloring or a drawing, it helps take your mind off of, you know, your fears or whatever you're thinking about. So I like the idea of these adult coloring books to help with anxiety. It's really a nice distraction. Let's see. How should I go about this? I think I want this to be really, really intense. The big circles. I'm just gonna color the parts that I think should be red. I want this to be red. I actually push down fairly hard when I color on these because I like my drawings, colorings, to be very vibrant. Every now and then, depending on how big the sections are that I'm coloring, I'll do some shading. But personally, with this drawing, the sections you know, push down pretty hard because I want it to look really, really vibrant and clear towards the end, you know. I want the final product to be very vibrant and clear. Very satisfying seeing your drawing become more colorful as you move on. I'm not sure if anybody's going to comment about it, but I do hold my pencil a little bit weird. I see most people hold like this, right? But I hold with my third finger, so it's kind of like, I know it's a little bit weird looking, but that's just how I learned how to hold a pencil. Main black and something black and yellow, black and orange, black and white. I'm not sure. Black and white might look kind of cool, don't you think? Well, I wanted you guys to know a little story about me. Horses are my favorite, absolute favorite animal. 9 years old. I would beg my parents to let me have one, but, you know, we didn't live anywhere that allowed horses, obviously. We lived in the suburbs, and I desperately, desperately wished that we lived on a farm. So, when my dad's job moved us to New Hampshire when I was 11, I saw that as an opportunity to beg my parents for horseback riding lessons. You know. Yeah, I was that girl. I really loved horses. Really, really loved them. They were very calming, adorable, sweet creatures. So, I begged my parents, and they finally agreed to let me have lessons. I was so happy. So, so happy. Oh. So I took lessons for almost 2 years in English horseback. Western, and then there's English. English is where you use, like, the reins to control the horse and your legs. And Western is where you have the horn on the front of the saddle. I don't know much about Western riding at all, but it seems like it's really fun. So do show jumping. I learned how to do cross country and dressage. But my favorite thing that I got to do was vaulting. Now, if you don't know what horse vaulting, just looking it up on YouTube, because it's really, really, really interesting. You'll be pretty amazed, I think. It's essentially gymnastics on horseback. And it's very fun to watch, but I can promise you, it's more fun to do. I really miss it. Thinking about making just the mane black and like black and then another solid color. Well, maybe black and white depending on what it ends up looking like. I'm not sure yet. We'll see. Anyway, so horse vaulting was really fun. My horse's name was Lola. She was this big, huge, big black horse, really tall, but also incredibly sweet. And she was only about 2 or 3 years old, so she was very, very young, but very, very well trained. I really loved her. I'd ride her in the snow and through the woods. I have very nice memories of those times. Then when we moved to Arizona again, my family couldn't afford the lessons, and it was really hard to find an equestrian area here in Arizona. So I kind of just gave up and started dancing again, because when I was doing horseback riding, I stopped dancing for a couple years. That's why when people ask me how long I've been dancing, I say, since I was 10, on and off. Because there were certain years where I didn't really take lessons in dance. be if I'd stayed in New Hampshire. You know? If I kept horseback riding. It was really good, actually. I'm not gonna lie. My trainer thought I was outstanding. She was really upset when I moved. And probably just as upset as I was. Because she wanted to enter me in a competition. Devastated about it. It's just not fair, you know. So having something you love just taken away. So any chance I get now to be around horses or to go horseback riding, I jump on it, you know. Just get so excited. I want to make this line darker here to match the lines around it. Really pretty. And the great thing about these coloring books is like you can just make them any color you want to be. I mean, if you're anxious and you're coloring, like you're really anxious, just like go crazy, color the whole horse black, you know, do whatever you want. Because honestly, coloring this is a great distraction, and I know that anybody with anxiety, trust me, somebody who suffers from panic disorder. Anyone with anxiety has an overactive mind. And your mind will make you think things that are not real when you're in the middle of an anxiety attack or when you're stressed. Your mind will tell you things that are not real. And then you'll dwell on those thoughts. And if you just take a moment, something like this, you'll realize there's no need to worry about what you're worrying about. It's not that important. It's not that serious. So I'm always looking for a distraction to keep my mind at ease, to help bring me back to reality. You know? So tiny. Yeah. Difficult. I'm gonna make this whole end black. Here we go. There we go. Oh no, that bothers me. Gotta make it bigger to fix that. There we go. Oh no, this part bothers me. I want the ends of these to be dark, very dark. I want this all to be black too. There we go, black, black, black. I like that. I also want this to be thicker, more black, less white. It's kind of nice when I make a mistake with the black and I can just use it as an excuse to color more around it black. I like that. I don't know if any, some of you guys may know, my favorite color is turquoise. Partial to the color black. I love the color black, especially with clothes. Oh, I need a pencil sharpener or something because it's getting kind of dull. Oh no, that's already black. Oh well. Mistakes if I don't sharpen this. Do I have a pencil sharpener? I don't think I even have one. Let the struggle begin. It's okay. I can do this without one, I think. I don't know. Probably not. We'll find out. I mean, it's not gonna look as good as if I did have a pencil sharpener. Make you darker too. All the outlines are gonna be dark. I'll outline it when I get. No, I'll just outline it now. At that, yeah. There we go. I think that it's nice to take a little break from the TV or the computer, and I'm no way saying that those are bad things because I love my TV and my computer a lot, but it's nice to take a break and kind of just go back to something you did when you were a kid, like coloring. Kind of has that calming effect. I spend too long on the computer, I can get a little antsy, a little more stressed out, stuff like that. I used to draw a lot when I was younger, in high school and middle school, but I don't really draw anymore. I just kind of stopped. So hard to do with a dull pencil. It's kind of silly that I don't have the pencil sharpener, but that's okay. keep twisting the pen, pencil around. I'll get it to work for me. Actually, you know what? I think I do have a pencil sharpener. I found a pencil sharpener. Tiny spots. Let's see here. Like I said, I'm gonna make all the tips black. This whole section is going to be black. Because I said so. Keep this black here too. Color this black. This part's very difficult for me to figure out. finish in all this black. So, I'm just gonna take it from here and make it all black. Because, yes, dark red, gonna go orange red. Take a jump here, make it a little lighter, finish that up, mixing with the black. Line the whole thing with black. Okay. Let's do this. Thank you. I'm gonna sharpen this again. A little bit over there. Okay. Almost done. So I believe I'm done. What do you think? Do you like it? Watching.